Hello, what is up, ladies and gentlemen? It is your maker 2199 bringing you guys another commentary. Now, I have a little fan on the background and I hope it doesn't come through the mic. And this is more of a trial just to see how it works, because it's really, really hot here already. It's getting close, it's beyond 80. it's starting to get closer to 90 actually over here where I live. And it's just been extremely hot. And I need to have the fan on or I'm gonna end up, you know, dehydrating or some shit. And on this one I want to talk about Diner. Now, I've played it a few times, like 3 or 4 times at most, and I'm really happy about that because I've been playing it a lot more than other maps. And I just want to give you guys my first impressions and then maybe get into a few tips and stuff like that on it, or a few locations or a few things that I've noticed people doing, but not really too much like a tips and tricks, just because I don't really have too many tips and tricks when I've only played it like 4 times, you know. It's just the truth. And right there, I'm pretty sure I just took out like basically the entire team by myself. And right there, I don't even know how I missed it, but I've been having a lot of trouble with this Nasher stuff. And right there, you know, I just keep on cleaning house. You know, I don't need any teammates, you know, fuck teammates. You know, I'll do it all by myself if I have to. And yeah, I don't know, this was a pretty good game. It wasn't as great, you know. I do have little bursts like this where I do tremendous, and then I have some bursts where I just can't, like, land shit. It's like the game trying to balance it out, I guess. I'm too good for it, and you know, it's trying to give other people a chance, because if I continue to play like this, you know, this would be over in like 5 minutes, you know, both rounds we would be done for. But yeah, I talk a lot of shit as well. But yeah, you know, and like I said, you know, this is the best channel to come. I know people like Gears of King of the Hill on Gears of War. It's one of the most played, you know, game modes other than Team Deathmatch. You know, I think Team Deathmatch for any game is going to be, you know, the most played game mode. But, you know, other than that, you know, this is a really good game mode. I know people don't like it because of the length, and I don't have too many King of the Hill games where they were super long or anything like that. You know, because I do have some where I do great, like fantastic, but they're 30 minutes or 40 minutes, and that to me isn't that fun. So I don't usually post stuff like that, you know. I only have one or two, and I cut it down on sections so it's easier to watch, I guess. But here, you know, I do believe that my channel is the best place to come and watch these little short King of the Hill matches, you know. It's an entire full game. I was on here throughout the full game. It's just so easy, so quickly paced, you know. We just dominated so fast and all of that it ended fast, you know. And a lot of other YouTubers that I watch, you know, they play Team Deathmatch and stuff like that for time reasons, you know, because they know that if they don't, they're gonna play for a really long time. And most of other YouTubers are King of the Hills are forever. And that's what I'm trying to avoid here, you know. So I think that's what gives my channel something a little bit different. You guys can come and enjoy King of the Hill and all of that, and you know, have it in an entire game on such a short little video, you know, less than 20 minutes. You know, that's what the Rage Quit series was about to begin with. And I think that I'm gonna continue to deliver on it, you know, especially when I keep on getting, you know, consistent games like this. You know, and I'm playing as much as I've been playing recently. You know, I'm gonna continue to deliver on that series and that, like, promise, I guess. But enough of that, you know. Diner here, it's a really good map, you know, and I really like the visuals, you know, the graphics on them, you know. They're really, really nice. And right there, I have no clue how I didn't kill him. I'm sure I headshotted his ass, but, you know, it didn't happen. But yeah, you know, it's a little laggy. This match was a little laggy because I was playing and uploading at the same time. And I have a few others that I did the same, and they're a little laggy, but it's alright, you know. It's my connection, you know. It could be better, but, you know, it is what it is, and I'll continue to play with it and, you know, dominate people either way. You know, you guys know, those of you that follow my channel, you already know how dominating I am some games, and others I'm not. You know, I'm not gonna lie, I have some good games and bad games like everybody. But I'm right, pretty sure I shot him right there, but you know, nothing happened. Except that I exploded in two, I guess. But yeah, Dider, you know, this is a map that we've seen before, you know, never on Gears of War, but the layout is nothing new. You know, if you guys remember Gears 3 Hotel, you know, it gives me that kind of vibe, you know, and what I really like about this map right now is that it doesn't have two layers. Like, it doesn't have any top section or everything. Everything is plain level field. You don't have any, you know, high advantage or anything like that. So that's pretty cool, you know. I like that everything is just there, but in the sense that to compare it to a past Gears of War map and how it should be played, I would say Hotel. You know, it does have a lot of differences, but a few similarities. You know, it has the inside-outside aspect to it, and it has a lot more than just inside-outside, you know. That guy actually thought he was gonna trick me. Like, I knew he had seen me since before. He knew I was coming, you know, so I was just trying not to get killed right there, not to fall, you know, for his crap. But yeah, you know, to continue with it, but you know, this visually, you know, Hotel was a beautiful, beautiful map, and I really liked it. I love that map, you know, for argument's sake. You know, I know a lot of people hated it, and I think this is because of the spawns on some weapons. You know, they were awkward, like the nades and all of that. You know, they were in situations where they were overpowering. And I think this map, you know, it's like they redeemed themselves, you know, after Hotel. You know, they really brought something back here, you know, like Hotel, but a lot more balanced, you know. That's basically what I can say about it. And it is just a gorgeous game. It's a really fun map to play, like, no doubt about it, you know. And the only bad thing about it, I would guess, is that in my opinion, it's a little too open. And like this area right here of the map, it has way too much cover. So people can take cover from different places, like right there. You saw her run away and then come and mantle kick me while I was picking up my teammate, you know? That's because it has way too much cover there. And right here, I think it's a little bit too much open, but, you know, to go back, that's how Hotel was, you know? There was an area that was super, super open, and then there was some other areas where it wasn't. And right there, I don't even know why she's trying to, you know, I kept on beating their asses. I don't even know why she was trying to, like, showboat or whatever. Like, really? You know, I always find that the people that suck the most are the ones that like showboating, you know, or they try to hump you and be all on your face, you know, like, dude, like, don't even, you know, you suck. You know, you're lucky because I was at a disadvantage when I went against her. You know, if she wouldn't have been at that situation, you know, I would have had the upper hand, like right here. You know, watch me get killed. Yeah, I knew it. Because I was reloading, and I think I missed it, so I think I got the red one, so it was going to take longer. But now to give you guys some tips, I guess. One of the things that I've noticed is inside this area, you got to be careful. A lot of people are going to jump over. Most people come through here, but then you see a lot of people back there just camping it, or people just waiting to jump over these areas, you know. They try to, like, loop around this little area and try to do circles. And this map has a lot to offer on these areas for wall bouncing. Just way too much. And yeah, you know, it's one of those maps where you are gonna have to wall bounce a ton in order to, you know, stay alive. If you miss, you know, wall bounce. Don't do what I do. I do it, I don't want to say out of view or anything like that, but I'm just that confident in my shots that I never plan to miss. I don't shoot and plan to miss. I think that everybody that wall bounces like a moron, you know, they already know that they were going to miss. You know, they know there was a high possibility that they were going to miss, and they're just wall bouncing just to save their ass. You know, they're not doing it to be strategic. They're just doing it to move out of the way and then just keep shooting randomly, you know, and hopefully something hits, I guess. But I don't play that way, so I don't really wall bounce that much. And that's because I'm really confident in my shot, you know. If I look at my stats, you know, my Nashorn, I think it should be more accurate. But it's not as accurate as I believe it should be, and there's a reason for it. The reason is that I think it's my connection, you know. It's a little bit laggy, it's a little bit awkward and all of that. But I think if I had a better connection, I would miss a lot less, and my accuracy would be a ton better, you know. But overall, you know, I think I'm pretty good, you know. I think I'm a pretty good player. I would call myself an average player, or maybe just very little above average or whatever. But enough of that, because I'm not giving you guys any tips. So on those areas, you know, be be aware, if you go right here to the right where all the seats are of the diner, you know, where your guests would be seated, I guess, and would be eating their food, you know, right there, it's an excellent place to wall bounce. I've seen people that wall bounce their dick off right there. You know, it is insane how wall bounce friendly it is. And right here, I'm not sure if she shot me with her ass or what, but she was rolling and she was looking at the other way when she shot me. I've seen a lot of that recently. I don't know if it's a glitch or what, but that really sucks. You know, right here, this is what I'm talking about. Where the robot went to follow this chick, I'm going over here to try to, you know, to try to stop her. But on that area, and I just shot her, not to steal a kill, but I shot her because they had a while down and I didn't want her to get up while I'm getting him up. And then this bitch pulls out an upset, you know, she kills both of us, and you know, I end up looking like a total retard, you know, like a total noob. And you know, I was gonna avoid that. And look at that little crab right there just hiding. You know, some people that play this shit are so afraid of their life just to like come out, you know, it's ridiculous. But yeah, you can wall bounce like crazy on some areas on this map. And for those of you that wall bounce, that is good news. For me, that's bad news, because having to shoot one of you motherfuckers when you're wall bouncing that crazy and you're dickless already, and I don't know, maybe you're trying to get that dick back or something, you know? You keep on bouncing like a maniac. You know, I don't even know, but it's hard to kill those wall bouncers, because the hitboxes are kind of glitch, you know, for a bit of time and that sort of stuff. So yeah, and right there, I should have let that. I don't know if that's the robot. I don't know if I had two robots, but I should have let him take him that kill because I took his. I had totally forgotten. I just remember right now that I'm watching it. But yeah, you know, right here, my best suggestion. Everybody always uses Lancers. Look at him, you know. And every time that I played it, that's always been the same. So my biggest suggestion. I had no clue anybody had the sniper, but my biggest suggestion is always just to. You know, if you're gonna go there, you know, I wouldn't want to use the Lancer, but if you have to hold it down, you know, that's the place to do it. And you see that that chick, you know, all these people, some of these people, all they do is just go in and out, you know, they don't really fight. You know, they're very cowardly, you know, I hate playing against cowardly players. And I'm not that big of a coward, you know, even if you go and hide behind cover, I'll still follow your ass, you know. Even if you have an advantage and you kill me, I don't care to give you a kill, you know. I refuse to play and just stay behind cover. You know, right here, we're just trying to hold it down because I know that we're going to win. And I don't want to pull out my Lancer or anything like that. So right here, you know, I faced him, you know. He had the superior shot. He won, you know. More credit to him, you know. But props to that guy for coming in balls in, you know. Balls to the wall, not having any fear. You know, that's my style of play, and that's what I like. You know, I like people like that, and it makes me want to keep on playing with them and all of that, because we're having actual battles, you know, and it's fun. Instead of just, you know, laying behind cover and doing nothing. But this is a map. Look at this bitch running away. She knew she was going to get her ass killed, and you see her pulling away. What a fag, you know? Like, really, like, you know, it pisses me off to see when people play like that. Especially when big YouTubers that talk so much shit that they're so good and that's all they do, you know, like stand and fight, you know, grab some balls, sir, you know. And I'm afraid, you know, I'm sorry that you didn't have some when you were born, but try to have some, you know, or have some dignity at least, you know. But it's really aggravating. But for this match, you know, the biggest thing that I can tell you is Insight is gonna be a Nasher fist. You know, right here, you can wall bounce like crazy. And if you're at the outside, you know, just be aware of freaking Lancers and Hammer Burst and all of that crap, you know. And right here, I'm trying to kill her, but my teammate got her, you know, which saved my life, because I was gonna die, actually. She was gonna more than likely kill me, and you're gonna see me fail like a crazy person. And I don't know if my teammate here got one or not, but yeah, right here, I was already out, and I had no clue. I actually thought that was a teammate. I had forgotten she was in there. And that's the same bitch that was crabbing it earlier on, where she was just, they threw a nade and she just went into a corner to hide. And that's all she kept on doing. And I've been seeing a lot of people that do that shit. They just like camp on a corner away from everyone, and their Nasher is like a Lancer or some shit. You know, they're sniping you from so far away. It's crazy. But yeah, I don't know. But this is a really fun map, you know, as long as you're inside, it's gonna be Nashor's. For those of you, which I think it's like 90% of people, you know, that like actually battles and all of that, and you know, Nashor's, and I don't even know why that guy is trying to like hunt me or whatever. I don't know what the fuck is his problem, you know. He's lucky that I don't have a mic, and I wasn't even playing hard or anything on this one, because I would have whooped them like I did on the beginning. And I would have continually whooped their ass if they kept up with this shit, you know, and if the match was gonna go for longer. But I've done it a lot of times, you know, and I played like that yesterday against a few folks that I don't know what the fuck was going on with them, you know. They were just like full of shit, you know, like they couldn't do shit. I wasn't doing much, they couldn't do shit or anything like that, and I kept on killing them, and it, like, I killed them like 20 times in the entire match, and they killed me once or twice, and they were all humping me or whatever. I'm like, dude, like, fuck off. You know, I got like 60 kills already, you know, and it was like a 40 minute match, and I'm like, I got like 60 something kills, dude, you have 20, like, get the fuck out of here with that bullshit. So I decided to do the same, you know, and it was just funny. But yeah, I really do like this match, and for those people that are gay and like Lancers, you know, the outside is for you. You know, and there's even a taco stand here. You guys can eat some tacos and wait, you know, outside the diner and all of that, while you wait for I guess the players to go outside and all of that. And inside, you know, I like the inside a lot better. But it's a really nice map, you know, the colors, everything, you know, it brings back a lot of memories, you know. And I'm gonna have Old Town shortly, but that's gonna be, I don't think I'm gonna cut it into sections, I'm gonna leave it as it is. I'm just gonna give you guys some tips on that one, because I've played a ton of it back in Gears 3, and we'll see what happens, you know. But I don't think I'm gonna talk for half an hour, you know, and I'm just gonna let you guys enjoy that gameplay and all of that, you know. It was pretty good. And I'm already promoting my next video. But yeah, you know, this is a really fun map, and if you haven't played it, you know, go ahead and, you know, play it, you know, check it out. It's better than some of the other maps for sure, you know. This is one map that I wish was on the regular rotation. It would be so beast, you know, it really would, you know. I trust me, you know, a lot of people would love this crap, you know. If it was, you know, a regular map and all of that, you know, a usual, it'll be really awesome. Thank you all. I'll see you guys on the next one. Like and sub.